everyone, welcome back to My Colourful Country Life. Today we're going to be colouring this Japanese-inspired snow globe page from Kerby Rosanes' Worlds Within Worlds.
Thank you. 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 Thank you.
Hey guys, editing Karen here. If you've been listening to the video on mute, hopefully you've unmuted and you can all hear me now. I just wanted to chat with you about the process for creating the background of this picture. Now, it took me a while to figure out what I wanted as a background, and all I could really come up with was a galaxy. But if any of you out there can draw, I think this would look really great with a forest background, perhaps some big cherry blossoms, maybe even a bridge or a lake. But sadly, I can't draw, so I decided on a galaxy background for this lovely floating snow globe. But what I was thinking of, you know those balls that when you touch them, they generate electricity that sort of shoots up to your fingers? I don't think I'm explaining that very well at all. If I can find a pic of what I'm talking about, I will put it up here. It's like when you touch it and the electricity current sort of follows your fingers around. I think they're called plasma balls, maybe. I'll see if I can find a picture and put it up there. But what I'm trying to explain is that I want it to look like a reverse version of that. So the same colours from inside the snow globe, but outside. Anyway, so what we are doing first is putting down our colours from lightest to darkest using very light layers. This is so we can see the colour placement and we can always add in more darkness or take it away when we do our final blend. So once we get this right, we will go over with a second layer. And that time, the second layer, we will be starting from the darkest shade and working back towards the lightest. And we'll be burnishing on that second layer. I then use Gamsol blending solution to smooth it out, and you can skip that step. I mainly use it as I had to erase some color transfer off the picture, and that ended up wearing down the tooth. So my layers weren't going on as smoothly as I would have liked. Also, it gives a sort of cloudy finish to the black. After that, we just finish it off by filling the background with stars using a white gel pen. Any white gel pen will do. It does take a while. It is time consuming. And I did spend the entire process cursing Kerby for giving me all this blank space. I hate blank space. Like, seriously, Kerby, you could have given me something to work with. Some trees, some grass, a window, a table, anything for my floating snow globe. Anyway, this was an experiment. I had my fingers crossed the entire time that I wouldn't ruin this picture. I think it turned out okay in the end. Let me know in the comments down below.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Alright guys, that's the end of our snow globe video. I hope you enjoyed it and thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again next time. Bye!